About 180 kilometers west of Barcelona, in the Spanish region of Catalunya, lies the city of Lleida. It is one of the oldest cities in Catalunya and has about 130,000 inhabitants. The city has quite a few tourist sites, but by far the most dominant is the Cathedral de la Sau Vella, overlooking the city. Apart from tourism, this city with its bustling city center on the River Segre also boasts a university and is an important business hub in the region. Lleida also has its own airport, Lleida-Alguaire, which opened in 2010. It is operated by the local government, but only a few scheduled flights operate from there. Though the potential for charter flights is definitely there, thanks to the proximity of ski resorts in the Pyrenees. Its distinctive control tower, next to the airport terminal, dominates the otherwise barren landscape around the airfield. This was the venue for the famous Festa al Cel in 2017, after the seaside town of Santa Susana ran into problems getting the event approved for security reasons by the authorities. On Saturday morning, spotters were allowed to see the participating aircraft from up close for free, as preparations took place for the airshow on late Saturday afternoon and on Sunday. First participants on Sunday morning were the Paramotors de Barcelona, a paramotoring school which operates from the airfield of Vilafranca del Penedès, though they can also be found on the Barcelona beaches out of season. They showed off their skills in an elegant three-ship aerial ballet. One of the great things about Festa al Cel is the strong local flavor, like with this carousel of the Aeroclub de Barcelona-Sabadell, a flight school which demonstrated a three-ship of Cessna 172 and 182s. Just like the Aeroclub de Barcelona-Sabadell, the Fundacio Parc Aeronautic de Catalunya operates from the airfield of Sabadell, and they presented this Beech T-34 Mentor and the Booker Jungmann, two classic training aircraft looking pristine in their Spanish Air Force colors. The Jungmann was built in Spain by Casa until the 1960s, and it was the primary training aircraft until 1968. The T-34 entered service in Spain in 1958 and stayed in use until the end of the 1980s with the Spanish Air Force Academy at San Javier. Perhaps overlooked by many, this MS-893 Rally was an important aircraft at Festa al Cel, serving as tow plane for the popular British GliderFX team. Here we see their two-seat Fox glider getting prepped to be attached to the tow plane on the runway. Once GliderFX's Ian Gallagher reached the appropriate altitude, he released from the tow plane to commence his fully aerobatic routine, showing just how agile the Fox is. Ian was an instructor with the RAF Gliding and Soaring Association at Chilterns and also flew with the RAF's Condor Glider team. He is now an instructor in human factors and safety management systems at RAF Gosford. The Fox he is presenting has a 14-meter wingspan and can take up to plus 9 and minus 6 G thanks to its largely composite construction. It is the twin-seat variant of the famous Polish Swift aerobatic glider, and its maneuverability is impressively clear with this performance. Here's the modern-day elementary training aircraft of the Polish Air Force, the PZL-130 Orlik. PZL is now part of Airbus military. The Orlik entered service with the Polish Air Force back in 1993 and has been receiving upgrades to bring it up to date over the past few years, which includes improved winglet and the Garmin avionics suite to give it a modern-day glass cockpit.
És un avió d'hèlix, com podeu comprovar, i està pensat per entrenament bàsic i avançat, entrenament de pilotatge sense visibilitat, entrenament d'atac amb blancos amb objectius aèris i terrestres i entrenament de navegació aèria, però també altament especialitzat en meteorologia. Aquí ho veieu. En aquest moment ha fet un semi-risc.
It is a performance aircraft which can take up to plus 7 and minus 3G. This aircraft comes from the Polish Air Force base at Radom. It is one of the planes of the Polish Air Force aerobatic team Orlik. Unfortunately, the full team had to cancel its participation at Festa al Cel due to a large military exercise in Poland at the time, but hopefully they will make it to Festa al Cel in the future.
I el grup acrobàtic es diu Orlik, que vol dir àguila. Potser d'aquí un parell d'anys el veiem aquí fent exhibicions amb oli de magdalena traient per la cua. A part, us ha fet gràcia això de la veritat, m'ho va explicar.
And another training aircraft. This is the Patrouille de France with 8 Alpha Jets advanced jet trainers, which are used for advanced jet pilot training with the French and Belgian Air Forces. Patrouille de France is based at Salon de Provence. Earlier in 2017, they went on a North American tour, which explains the adapted color schemes on the tails of the team's Alpha Jets. Leading the team is Commandant Christophe Dubois, a former Mirage 2000 fighter pilot.
Thank you.
see Spanish paratroopers descending on Lleida-Alguaire, having jumped from a CH-47 Chinook.
Veieu que també van fent derivant lentament, fent espirals molt obertes per anar fent cap a terra.
Parachutists are always popular at air shows with their precision landings in front of the crowd. And here is the CH-47 the troops jumped from. It performed a short demonstration showing off its agility despite its considerable size. Spanish CH-47s are part of FAMET, the Spanish Air Mobile Brigade. Spanish Army CH-47s are based at the base of Colmenar Viejo in central Spain, north of Madrid. Seventeen of these powerful machines are in service with FAMET, with Battalion Beltra 5. And here we see the Chinook demonstrating its cargo sling capability underneath the fuselage. We stay with vertical flight. This is the AV-8B Harrier 2, or rather the Matador in Spanish service. Of these vertical takeoff and landing capable jets are in service with the Armada. These can operate from the Juan Carlos I amphibious assault ship when they are not at their home base in Rota. Even after all these years, seeing this aircraft hovering steadily in front of the audience remains an awe-inspiring sight. This is a second EF-18 that accompanied the display EF-18 on both days of the show when they flew in from their home base at Zaragoza. The aircraft is known to most as the EF-18 Hornet, but in Spanish service it is actually designated the C-15. The Tiger marking on this aircraft denotes that it's part of ALA 15, a member of the NATO Tiger Association. Spanish Air Force also has a second EF-18 base located in Torrejon near Madrid. Spanish Hornets have undergone major upgrades and they have been supplemented with the EF-2000 Typhoons as the Spanish Air Force's main combat aircraft. Here we see a Spanish Air Force A400M coming over from Zaragoza, where it is part of ALA 31. These four-engine transport aircraft are brand new in the Spanish inventory, so seeing one for a few flypasts was a treat.
Para aterrizaje puede aterrizar en pistas de 820 metros y radio de tierra de 18 metros. Este avión también tiene el Zaragoza y es el Airbus A400M Atlas.
We saw two classic elementary Spanish training aircraft earlier. Here we see the modern-day Spanish advanced jet trainer, the Spanish-built Casa 101 Aviojet, in the hands of the pilots of the Spanish Air Force aerobatic team Patrulla Aguila, the Eagle Patrol.
Suyo es el puesto de mayor responsabilidad. Ahí vemos cómo van completando este looping en cuña.
Patrulla Aguila is part of the Spanish Air Force Academy at Murcia San Javier, located on the southeast coast of Spain.
Información porque en el punto número 4 el capitán Juan Ruiz se encuentra rodeado del resto de los aviones, lo que obliga a que las correcciones sean muy muy suaves para que no exista conflicto.
All pilots in the team are flying instructors at the Air Force Academy and have to fit in their team duties with their regular flight instructor operations. The team was established in 1985, and since 1987 they have been a familiar and welcome sight at air shows around Europe, drawing the Spanish flag in the skies, being one of the rare teams that also uses yellow smoke during its routine.
Completando parsimoniosamente, perfecta la ejecución de este tonel. Vamos a darle un fuerte aplauso a la patrulla que acaban de completar este. Vamos a darle una fuerte aplauso a la patrulla Aguila en formación FACA. Que va a iniciar este 360 para una pasada posterior en formación Águila. Esta es una maniobra que nosotros conocemos con el nombre de torniquete. Ahí vemos el cambio Águila. Y vamos a estar muy atentos.
2017 was the first year for the first female pilot on the team, flying the number 2 position. Enjoy this display by the Patrulla Aguila while the sun set on Saturday evening. Another sunset display was performed by the popular F-16 solo display of the Belgian Air Force. Commandant Tom Gizmo de Morto and his special painted F-16 Blizzard lit up the evening Spanish skies with a blazing afterburner and lots of flares. Flares are decoys in combat to mislead heat-seeking missiles following the heat of the aircraft's powerful Pratt & Whitney engine. Tom comes from the Belgian Air Force base at Kleinebrovel, one of two Belgian F-16 bases. Festa al Cel was one of Gizmo's last public displays. In 2018, the responsibility of the Belgian F-16 display shifts to Florent for 3 seasons. Having missed its original slot, the Spanish Army NH-90 Cayman performed its solo display during the sunset on Saturday. This helicopter is in service in the Spanish Army since 2016, with a total of 22 helicopters to be delivered by 2021. The Spanish Army NH-90s are assembled at the Airbus military factory plant at Albacete near Madrid. The helicopter is tasked with troop transport, search and rescue, and medical evacuation. This helicopter is stationed at Agoncillo for pilot training and conversion as more NH-90s enter service in the Spanish military. We already saw the British GliderFX team in action earlier on, but here is Ian Gallagher during the Saturday dusk display with the Fox glider getting towed to altitude by the rally once more.
Hello.
The display was a true feast for fans of lighting effects and pyrotechnics. Seeing the display in the very dark skies over Lleida-Alguaire was very special, and the audience showed its appreciation with loud cheers. With the landing of Ian Gallagher and the Fox, we conclude our look back at the most enjoyable Festa al Cel 2017. Despite the late problems with the original seaside location, the organization overcame the challenges and last-minute move to this new site and managed to present the audience with 2 days of enjoyable flying action. Let's hope the new location at Lleida-Alguaire will bring Festa al Cel to new heights in the future.